Welcome to Spirit Cocktails. I'm your host, Pierre. Today we're making the Guardians of the Galaxy Infinity Power Gem. This is actually a cool idea for a cocktail I had, and it definitely takes some preparation ahead of time. You don't want to just get ready to do it and then have it done in the same moment, because you got to give it a few hours prior, because what you're doing to make the gem is you're creating an ice ball of fruit juice and also pearl dust. That's what gives it the idea of the Infinity Power Gem. If you look at the Guardians of the Galaxy movie, Power Gem is purple. Some people say the Power Gem actually should be red, but maybe not. But in the movie, it's purple, so I figure why not? Maybe some coloring problem they had otherwise. But to make this, it's simple. You want to give it about 4 hours prior to actually making this, because all it is an ounce of grapefruit juice, ounce and a half of cranberry juice, half ounce orgeat syrup, a few dashes of silver pearl dust, as well as the blue pearl dust. Because when you get those together, you're going to give it more of a silvery... Make that stand up. Screw it. You can give it more of a silvery, glowing, crystallized look to it. And then you also have the blue with the red. It's going to make it purple. So, as you can see, the only bad thing about doing this is if you ever bought Vanique, you let it sit. All the pearl dust stuff sells to the bottom. This has to literally sit for a few hours. Unless your refrigerator is, your freezer is extremely cold and it's going to freeze this in a matter of like an hour, you're going to have some settling of the color. It's still going to keep the ball a purple color. That's still going to be intact. But you're going to have a lot of your pearl dust settle to the bottom. So it's not going to be a complete blend. I mean, you could probably go back in your freezer like half hour intervals. Just give it a little bit of a shake. That may actually mix up a little too much. But either way, it's still a good cocktail. It's going to be a good idea. And this is going to be black, just like it is in the actual movie, as far as the orb. Black and silver. But I'll show you how this one's made. So I put this aside for now. And we're going to create the containment orb. The containment orb is going to be a shake and strain. Obviously, because you're using the pearl dust, you want to make sure everything is nice, combined and mixed together. So the first thing you want to do, well, before you do that, add some ice. Actually, that's good. Now if you want, ahead of time, put your ball inside your glass. So you want to take an ounce of white rum. Half ounce triple sec. Then a half ounce of your peach schnapps. Then you want to take a few dashes of your black pearl dust. You want to put a decent amount in it so it gets a nice dark black color. And a few dashes of your silver. Give it a shake and strain. And you should have a nice, dark, almost like silverish color. More of a grayish. And take that. Pour into your glass. Top it with Sprite. There you have it. The Guardians of the Galaxy Infinity Power Gem. So it's definitely going to have a lot more infusion of flavors. Because you already got the peach, you got the rum, you got the orange from the triple sec. Obviously you got the orange lemon flavor from the Sprite. And then as your ball melts, that flavor is going to be infused into that cocktail. So you'll be getting a lot of the grapefruit, the cranberry, the almond or jeet syrup. You're going to get all that flavor as you drink this. It's going to blend into the cocktail. So it's a cocktail you don't want to just drink in one shot. You want to let it sit for a while. Take a few sips here and there to help get all that flavor slowly coming into the cocktail, making a completely new cocktail experience with every sip. See how it tastes. It's actually really good. Now, I let this sit for a while. It's going to taste so much better because you're going to get all that sweet flavor from the cranberry and everything. As of now, you're definitely getting the peach schnapps flavor coming out. The rum blends really well with that. The thing that's really cool about this is it is that dark black silver color, kind of like the orb that you see in the movie. And then you got the power gem sitting right in the middle. So it's a really good cocktail. It said it does take a little bit of setup time. You can buy these. I did a review for these earlier. You can check out my review if you want to learn more about this. The idea of an ice ball compared to a regular ice cube, it does take longer to melt. It keeps your drink colder longer, and it doesn't water it down as much. But this is a really good idea. You can check out my review. I'll put a link in here. And also, if you get a hold of them, you can do pretty much anything with these. You can say if you have a party coming, and you just, even if it's a non-alcoholic party, if you just have like maybe a bunch of kids coming over and you want to have like a birthday party for them, make a whole bunch of these ahead of time. Just take some water, add some food coloring into it, freeze them, just make just any color you possibly can. If you want, do the same idea with this, where you can add some pearl dust to it, give it a unique glowing glittery flavor or glittery look. Guaranteed, if you had this for a bunch of kids with all the glitter and everything, they're going to go crazy over it. Just sit that, put it right inside their cup of Sprite, and then as it melts, it's going to take that color and the glitter and just blend throughout the whole cocktail or the whole drink. It's a really good idea to have these. I'm really happy about this. I really like it, and I can use it many times. This is perfect if you want to have for your whiskey too, just because it doesn't water down that much. But definitely check out the review. If you get a chance to make this cocktail, definitely, it's really good. I mean, even initially, before that melts, it's good. As it melts, it's going to be so much better because you're getting all that flavor in there. See, right away. First sip, you're getting a lot of the peach flavor, the rum and things like that, and Sprite, a lot of the citrus. Just that little amount of that sitting there, the ice ball with all the fruit flavors started to melt, and it started blending into the cocktail. So you're getting all that flavor infusion just throughout the whole cocktail. That's why this is a cocktail experience you're going to love, and it's going to change with each sip. But I hope you enjoyed this. Let me know what you think in the comments below. If you got a chance to buy Casino ice balls or any ice ball, any type ideas for cocktails that you think of doing, even in a situation like this. I mean, you can maybe make like a beer ball. The only thing I would suggest, anytime you use anything carbonated in these, they have a fill line. I don't know if you can see it on the video, because it's a real light line. But right about there, there's a fill line. Maybe put just below, because water itself, as I said, has a little bit more of oxygen in there, so it's going to cause it to crystallize, and then the air bubbles are going to fill it more, which is the main reason why you want to fill it below that line, because it's going to come out of the top regardless. So I say maybe a quarter inch below it, and it'd be fine. Then you can have like your beer. Maybe make a Guinness. Make some beer Guinness, put some Irish cream on the outside, and as that Guinness starts to melt, you basically have a Guinness float. There's a lot of things you could do with these. I love them. definitely suggest you try it out. Check out my review. As always, like us on Facebook, Concept Spirit Cocktails. Subscribe to our channel. Send your recipes to me. If you have any ideas for ice ball cocktails, send them. You'll find a link below. You can also find my email, sbcrecipes.com, or sbcrecipes@gmail.com. Send them to me. I'll be sure to make them. But as always, drink responsibly.